One connection for options. Today we are dealing with an everyday task in steel design. Two beams are to be connected to each other, and this can of course be done in various ways. Today's option 1, the double end plate connection. Here we use the end plate tool and first select the beam to be connected, and then the face on which the end plate should be placed on the second beam. We choose a double plate, then we can select the suitable preset in the selection and also get a preview immediately. The length doesn't quite fit yet, but it can be adjusted in the settings down here. Now it fits and we can confirm. The computer now works for us and shortens, for example, the beam to the appropriate length. Finished! That was fast. We continue with the second option, the clip angle connection. Same situation as before. Here we start with the cope beam end tool. We first select the beam where we want to add the notch and then the other beam. The preview appears immediately and now we adjust the dimensions as desired. Confirm and step 1 is done. Time for the clip angle connection tool. As always in SolidSteel, the faces involved are selected and then the suitable part, in this case a clip, from the list. Confirm and then the same again on the other side. Looks already good, but a few bolts would not be bad. We use the manual boltings tool, which allows us to easily account for the different clamp lengths of the bolts. Multiple boltings can be added at once. Just select the beginning and the end of the holes and click on Add Bolt. Clicking on Assemble opens the next dialog, where we can first select bolt type, standard, length, diameter, thread, etc. and then click on Add. Another click on default mountings ensures that the matching washers and nuts are also included. Confirm and the boltings are in place. We add the still missing shorter bolts in the same way. Well, the angle connection is now also finished. Back at the start. Now comes the third option, the connection with a small non-bending resistant end plate at the web of the beam. As with the angle connection, a coping is inserted first. You already know how to do that. Again we use the end plate tool in exactly the same way as in the first example. The only difference is that we only place a single plate and here the dimensions are much smaller than with the first plate. Confirm and our third example is finished. Now we are already at the fourth and last example of this video. The connection with a gusset plate. To do this we use the tool of the same name and again first select the desired face on the source beam and then the face on the target beam. Again we set the dimensions as desired and the 130mm I'm typing here define where the source beam will be cut later. Okay, that was too small. The gusset may be a bit higher. The whole pattern defines the rest of the geometry. Now we add the screws as usual. Looks good, we can confirm that. We could save this connection or also the second example with the clip angle connections with the complete bolting in order to use it in exactly the same way again and again without having to add the bolts manually each time. This of course saves a lot of time and effort. That's it for today. Four common connections were shown and you now know how easy they are to design with SolidSteel parametric for SolidWorks. If you found this video useful, feel free to show it with a like or by subscribing to the channel. See you next time.